unexpected. You changed my life. I hope you know. 'Cause now I'm lost, so unprotected. In the blink of an eye, I never got to say goodbye. Like a shooting star, flying across the room. So fast, so far, you got too soon. You're part of me, and I'll never be the same here without you. You've gone too soon.
We are here today in honor of little Carson Shane Bailey, who was born into the arms of Jesus January 1st, 2021, here in Nacogdoches, Texas. He is survived by mom and dad, Ashley Ann Holland, Cody Shane Bailey, siblings Camden Bailey and Adley Bailey, aunts and uncles Courtney Bailey, Shayna Tucker, Rochelle Chandler, Dylan Holland, and Derek Holland, grandparents Mary Brown Holland and Relissa and Shane Bailey, cousins Kaysen Kennedy, Bailey Tucker, Emerson Tucker, Presley Parnell, Preston Parnell, Avery Bond, Kyler Bond, and Chance Bond. Joining in heaven, great-grandparents Wayne and Clarky Brown, Rosalind Bailey, Joycey Chandler, and Charles Chandler. And I would like to read this poem to Cody and Ashley this morning. Daddy, please don't look so sad. Mama, please don't cry. 'Cause I'm in the arms of Jesus and he sings me lullabies. Please try not to question God. Don't think he is unkind. Don't think he sent me to you and then he changed his mind. You see, I'm a special child and I'm needed above. I'm the special gift you gave him, the product of your love. I'll always be there with you and watch the sky at night. Find the brightest star that's gleaming. That's my halo's brilliant light. You see me in the morning frost that mist your window pane, That's me in the summer showers. I'll be dancing in the rain. When you feel a little breeze from a gentle wind that blows, that's me, I'll be there, planting a kiss on your nose. When you see a child playing and your heart feels a little tug, that's me, I'll be there, giving your heart a hug. So Daddy, please don't look so sad. Mama, don't cry. I'm in the arms of Jesus, and he sings me lullabies. From your little angel, Carson Shane Bailey.
Tell me, what does it look like in heaven? Is it peaceful? Is it free like they say? Does the sun shine bright forever? Have your fears and your pain gone away? Cause here on earth it feels like everything good is missing since you left.
I would like to say this morning that as a minister, you know that when you take the call and the call of God to be a minister, that you know you have to do funerals, but you never look forward to funerals like this because babies aren't supposed to die. And I would like to tell Cody and Ashley that our thoughts and prayers are with y'all. Several times I've went to y'all's Facebook page and I can't even look at the picture because it tears me up so inside so much, and I can't imagine what you're going through right now. But I want you both to know that nothing happens with God by mistake. And this morning, I now pastor a church in Victoria, and I drove in last night. This morning I was at my parents' house, and I was gathering my thoughts because in moments like this, you reach for comfort. You reach for answers, and there's really nothing that I can say that can bring you comfort or that can take this pain away. But this morning in Philippians chapter 4, verse 7, and it says, "And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding." And so what that means is that when I don't understand the situation, when something comes into my life that I don't have the answer to, the Bible says that there is a peace from God in those moments when you least expect it, that just shows up in times of hurt, and it gives you peace. Regardless of the hurt, at some point in some time, you're going to experience that peace from God. And it says, "It shall keep your hearts and minds through Jesus Christ." And so in moments like this, in heartache, the one area or the one being that we need to reach for is God. And sometimes people make the mistake of reaching for other things to satisfy that hurt than God. But I want to tell you today that the Bible describes him as wonderful counselor. He's a counselor, which meaning in times where you don't understand, you can go to him and talk to him. The mighty God, the everlasting Father, and the Bible says he is the Prince of Peace. And in 2 Corinthians 1, it says that he is the God of all comfort. The God of all comfort. And it's hard for us to fathom where you are right now because some people cannot relate to where you are right now. Some people cannot relate. There are some people that can relate that has been through similar situations of loss. But the Bible says that he is the God of all comfort. And I want to tell you both something here today, that God knows exactly where you are. God knows exactly what you're going through. And if you will allow him, he will help you through this process. It says, who comforteth us in all our tribulation. That means when I'm going through something as devastational as this, that I don't understand, that he's a comfort in all our tribulation. But why is he a comfort in that tribulation? That we may be able to comfort them which are in any trouble. And so this morning, sitting on my dad's couch, you know, I am a preacher, I'm a minister. I don't have a booklet of sermons that I go to. In fact, sometimes I don't even read my Bible until I feel God put something in my spirit. And when Cody asked my father to do this service, I did not realize that he also asked me. And later that evening, I was re-looking back at the messages, and I saw where he said, "You or your dad," and I felt a touch in my spirit, like I needed to come and be a part of this service. And I didn't get a booklet and say, "What can I say?" No, I said, "God, I want you to give me something that I can give to this family from you," because I'm not interested in my own personal words. If I believe in God, then I also believe that he has the power to speak to us directly, and he has the power to help us directly. And Cody and Ashley, what I felt like this morning is that as tough as this situation is, one day you are going to be able to help someone that is in your situation right now. Because time heals all wounds. And there's going to come a time where you'll never forget this sweet little baby. You will never forget the baby. But over time, the pain will get better. And there's going to be another family that God puts in your life that is going through the same situation that you are right now, that God is going to put you there so you can help them get through the situation and say, hey, I can speak from experience that he's the comforter. I can speak from experience that he is the counselor. In Matthew chapter 5, it said, blessed are they that mourn. This is Jesus talking. Blessed are they that mourn. Let's think about that for a second, because sometimes it's like that doesn't make sense. Blessed, I'm blessed when I mourn? Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. And this morning, Ashley, as I was thinking about you, and I grew up with Cody. Me and Cody go way back, way back. I was talking to him this morning of crazy things that we done in high school. But you know, the thought of Moses, who helped lead the children of Israel out of Egypt, his mother was living in a time where the king put out a decree to kill all the little baby boys. And she made a basket, and she put this baby in this basket, and she had to put him in a river, not knowing what was going to happen, but she trusted that there was a reason. And as hard as it is for you to see your baby up here, you have put him back in the hands of God. I have to come to the realization of my little girl that I have now, before she was given to me, she belongs to Jesus. And you as a mother, nobody knows really what a mother's going through because you carried it all those times. Us fathers sometimes has a hard time really being able to relate. But I want you to know that your baby today is back in the arms of Jesus, as hard as that is to say, and that he will comfort you. Understand something, that when Jesus came to earth, a part of his ministry, right? Ministry is there to help people, to support people. A part of his ministry was to heal them that were brokenhearted. And so when I am brokenhearted, that allows an opportunity for God to come in my life, because Jesus said, them that are whole have no need of a physician. I didn't come to touch them that are whole. I came to touch them that are going through situations like you're going through here this morning. And I want to thank y'all, and this is just me being real this morning. I want to thank you for giving this baby a proper service. Because in the world that we live in today, there is so many terrible things being done to babies. And y'all have taken upon yourself to give this baby a proper service. And I, from the bottom of my heart, I thank you. Because regardless of what society says, that's a little life in there. And the Bible says that children are a heritage from the Lord. What does that mean? That means it's an inheritance from God, which means it belongs to him first. And this morning, and as I was looking over my notes and trying to get something to say in this service, I went to passages where I saw Jesus talk about children. And the Bible says that in Matthew chapter 19, that they brought the children to Jesus. And Jesus put his hands on them and he touched them. And he said, suffer the little children and forbid them not to come to me. The disciples rebuked the little children because in that time in society, children were considered an outcast. And so when the children came up to Jesus, the disciples said, get the children away from him. But Jesus stopped everything and said, hang on a second, bring the children to me. Why did Jesus say that? Because he said, for such is the kingdom of heaven. And so when I looked over the last several days, Cody, when I looked at your profile picture of you holding little Carson, Ashley, when I looked at your profile picture of you holding little Carson, and even the time where you said, I wish I could change places with him, you know what you was holding in that moment? You was holding a little piece of heaven. Children are little pieces of heaven that God puts in our life. And Jesus said this. He said, talking to his disciples who are full grown, and this goes for all of us here today who are full grown, minus the children. Jesus said, except you be converted and become as a little child, you shall in no wise enter into the kingdom of heaven. What was Jesus referencing? He was talking about the purity and the innocence of a child, quick to forgive, quick to love, tender. And so sometimes when you're in your situation today, it does help to know that other people has been where you are. And if they can make it, I can make it. And Job, who was a man in the Bible, one day lost every single thing that he had. All of his houses, his living, his cattle, everything. And he lost all of his children. And at the end of after losing everything, this is what he said. The Lord gives and the Lord takes. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And as hard as that is to say, as hard as that is to utter, God gives and God takes, but blessed be the name of the Lord. And in closing here, I'm not going to be too long this morning, but in closing, Jesus in Luke chapter 22 is fixing to be crucified. He knows that he's fixing to have to die for the sins of the world. And he's praying to the Father. And he says, Father, if it's possible, let this cup pass from me. But nevertheless, not my will, but your will be done. In other words, the cup represented the pain that he was experiencing. And no doubt, if y'all had the power today to change this situation, you would. I would. If I had the power to change it, I would. But there's a higher power that is at work here. And I have to trust that he has baby Carson in his best interest. And as hard as it is to pray that prayer that says, God, I don't want to have to experience this. I don't want to have to go through this. I don't want to have to bury my baby. Please take this from me. Please change this. How many of you sitting in under the sound of my voice today has ever been in situations like that? Where you just say, God, please change it. God, please take it away. That's what Jesus is saying. Jesus is in the same exact situation that says, hey, please change it. Please take it away. Nevertheless, not my will, but thy will be done. The Bible says all things work together good for them that love God. All things. It did not say, now listen here, it did not say all good things. Because we want good things to happen to us. We're happy when good things happen. We're blessed when good things happen. But the Bible says all things work together good. So as devastational as this is, God is going to make this work for your good some way, somehow. And this is what draws me peace this morning. Because the Bible says in Hebrews chapter 4 that we have not an high priest which cannot be touched with the feelings of our infirmities. Infirmities means pain. In other words, he was touched with the feelings of our infirmities. In other words, he has felt what you feel. He has been where you are. He knows what it's like to face rejection. He knows what it's like to face loss. But there's a reason why he put himself in the situation long before we ever get in those situations. Because the Bible says, so therefore, let us come boldly unto the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. So the reason why Jesus put himself before you and in situations of hurt and pain to endure it is so he could know what you were going to go through and feel it. I went through police academy one time. And I was not called to be a police officer, okay? But they come time to spray me with pepper spray. And I'm like, why are y'all fixing to spray me with pepper spray? They said, because we want you to feel what you could possibly put somebody else through. And I'm telling you, that is the worst pain. You know, people say giving birth is the worst pain. I'm telling you, pepper spray has got to be somewhere up there. Because after I was pepper sprayed in the face, somebody could have done the worst thing and I would have still thought twice about spraying them. And so Jesus has put himself in these situations so he could know what you're going through. Nobody knows the pain like you're going through today like Jesus does. But the reason why he felt it is so you could come boldly before him. Ashley, when nobody else is around and you're in your house all by yourself and you feel the pain and the agony, you can cry out to God. That boldly says, I can scream if I want to. You know, a lot of people pray, they pray like, thank you, Jesus. And there's nothing wrong with that. But you know, you can lift up your voice and pray. You can scream out to God, God, please help me. He says, I'm going to give you this opportunity to come boldly that you may have help in the time of need. And so in the days going forward, I want you to know the closest person to you is not your family. The closest person to you is not your children or Cody. The closest being in power to you is God. And you cry out to God. When you don't understand, you cry out to God. Anger or frustration or hurt. I don't know why I feel such a draw to you today, but I want to tell you something today. Anger, frustration, hurt, devastation needs an outlet. A lot of times people, they stick it, when they go through situations like this, they harbor it. They harbor it and they release it on things. But do you know God said that you bring me your heavy burdens. You bring me your pain. And so when you need to let all of that out, you go somewhere in your house or some room when nobody else is around, the kids ain't around, and you cry out to God. God, the help that is available to me through what your word says, that's what I need. And I'm telling you by the power of the Holy Ghost that God will help you. And Cody, God will help you. But what we have to do is we have to allow this situation in our life, number one, to trust God more and to draw us closer to him. And so as bad as this is, there's beauty in pain. I'm telling you, it's blessed. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. And so you're going to experience times. If you cry out to God and you pray, Jesus, I know you already have, but I'm saying there are going to be times greater in the future that God is just going to come down and wrap his arms around you and be your comfort and be your peace and be your counselor. And so today, as we're concluding, we're going to pray. And the rest of us here, I would like you to pray for Cody and Ashley. I want you to pray that the peace of God would rest upon their home, would rest upon their lives, that from this moment on, that he would be a help and a comfort to them. Okay? So you pray in whatever way you know how, or whatever way you pray, and we're all going to pray together, can we? God, I come before you today, and I thank you for this life, God, that you have given and that you have taken back. Today, God, I pray for Cody, and I pray for Ashley. I pray for whatever they are going through, God, whatever the questions that they have, God, that you would give them the answer. Whatever the turmoil in their spirit or the hurt, God, I'm asking you right now to be a peace and a comfort to them in the days ahead. I ask you, God, to use this situation to benefit them and to benefit their family in whatever way that you see fit, God. We thank you today for the opportunity to come before you and to thank you for this life. And I thank you for this family, God. I'm asking you to bless Cody and Ashley. I'm asking you, God, to be a peace and a help and a comfort to them. And we're going to give you all the praise for it. And in times where they don't understand, God, I pray that you're even a greater presence in their life. I pray, God, that they would cry out to you and give all their frustration and all their hurt over to you, as you're more than able to bear it, and you're more than able to take care of it. And we ask all this in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Amen.
Get where I'm going on the far side of the sky. The first thing that I'm gonna do is spread my wings and fly. I'm gonna land beside a lion and run my fingers through his mane, or I might find out what it's like to ride a drop of rain. Yeah, when I get where I'm going,
there'll be only happy tears. I will shed the sins and struggles I have carried all these years, and I'll leave my heart wide open. I will love and have no fear. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, don't cry for me down here. I'm gonna walk with my granddaddy, and he'll match me step for step, and I'll tell him how I've missed him.